tide is another time to be with him. This is Chidi Kalu, and I have with me James Adefri. Together we'll be talking about something that is so pertinent to us, about real estate and how we can leverage on real estate investment, take it from one level to another level, building cash flow, building residual income for ourselves. Yesterday on Facebook, I had some people who called in, and also had people who sent in messages concerning how can you transform 200,000 naira into 7 million in 24 months. And I started discussing, and we started engaging people on how each person can make 200,000 naira become something that will be translated into cash flow, that will translate into cash flow when it comes to real estate investment. So today we'll just be doing something that we call the underground real estate investment economy, and how you can partake with just about 200,000 naira, and how you can also invest in real estate starting from wherever you are. Some people believe that real estate is not for them, so they rid themselves from the opportunity that real estate presents. So today, what we're going to be doing today is that we're going to be doing a brief of analysis. So we're doing some write-up, and that's why we have a board behind us. So we're doing a write-up. We'll be looking at a particular, how we can, we'll be analyzing projects together and see how we can take that one particular project and how you can partake investing in that particular project. So today, we are going to be discussing the underground real estate investment economy and how you can be part of it. Now, James, can anybody invest in real estate?
Yeah, practically anybody can invest in real estate as long as you have some sort of income coming in from it. Even maybe from you being in primary school, except that you're still under age, but at least when you're 18 and all that, maybe when you start getting some sort of pocket money from your parents and all that. And believe it's something you should look at, or it's even something we need to start training our children into to do, because it's a very good way to just make it big within a very short period of time, and you just build your residual income over time.
Now, some people will want to know how long will it take? Is it practical for me to be able to invest with the little amount that one has? Because basically, for anybody who's probably watching at this particular time, I started real estate with almost nothing, and anybody can do real estate with almost nothing. But at this particular stage, we are looking at, okay, what can you do currently now, investing in a particular portfolio that you can take advantage of and build residual income for in real estate. So today, we are going to be looking at how we can use real estate and build an economy for ourselves. So how practical is it for anybody to invest in real estate?
It's really very practical. But the other side of it is just the fact that, fine, it's going to be very tedious, because one thing with real estate is if you want to do it a very good way, you need some sort of pile of cash to pay that, which might not be practically available to everybody. But what people tend to do is maybe try to get some sort of fund, buy land and all that. But however it is, and however we want to look at it, if you have the land, for instance, let's say in Agbara, Ebikuru, and all that, you just have that land there. And you might not actually be maximizing the full potential of that land, because maybe worst case, what you can do with that land at any particular point in time will maybe do farming of some sort, and maybe it will like take 10 years before it will appreciate a good time. But if you actually want a property that will appreciate maybe within a space of a very short period of time, and you start looking at you buying a land worth of 200,000 naira, and maybe in another 10 years you are able to sell such land for 10 million naira, that kind of a thing, then you shouldn't be tending towards areas like the outskirts. You should be able to do that within the city. So when we now start saying what can we do within the city, because I don't think if everybody can afford to live in the city, nobody will go to the more you tend to move away from the city, the more insecure and all that you get to, going to lots of things that are just flying around now, like the Badu boys case and every other thing. So I believe if we can get to come together, do some sort of a partnership, put funds together, then we can be able to now start making a project we can do together, and when we know what return on investment we can get, then I believe that is one thing anybody can do.
For anybody who wants to maybe generate cash flow from whatever they are doing, especially when it comes to real estate, you don't have to buy a property that is not going to generate you income regularly. You need to think in terms of cash flow. You need to think in terms of maximizing serious cash flow potential from your investment. And so for you to be able to generate serious potential, maximizing serious potential cash flow from your property, all you currently need to do now is to be able to invest in areas that will give you, or in projects that will give you good returns. Somebody was speaking to me yesterday, and the person was like, you know what, I want to buy a property somewhere in Abeokuta, and I want to invest 200,000 naira doing so. And the person is expecting that, okay, over time, the property will appreciate. But I know that over time, that is not a very good strategy. What is a good strategy is that, okay, you invest in cash flow projects, that your 200,000 naira can actually fetch you good returns. I'm going to just do a practical example of what we actually mean by that, and how you can take advantage of that opportunity. Now, with 200,000 naira, how feasible is anybody, is it to be able to generate income from your platform?
With 200,000 naira, it is really very feasible in the sense that what we'll now try to look at is look for some sort of property within the city. There is what they call some sort of developer finance stuff. So I guess some families are now looking for, because maybe they don't have the financial capability to actually develop their property. Or maybe it's the case of Lagos State government trying to flag their property for whatever reason, that they should need to, or there is a need for them to either demolish such property. And if they don't demolish it, Lagos State government will take it from them. And I guess sometime there was a publication in the National Gaming where Lagos State is telling some property owners maybe in the very good areas in Lagos that maybe the property had been abandoned for God knows how long. A very good example is this casino cinema at very close to Sabo.
Yeah.
And I believe that just within that short period of time, I guess whoever is concerned is just now willing to let it go to whoever has that fund to do such projects. Okay. So when we now, we will not just need to start scouting for properties that we can do. It doesn't necessarily mean doing something that like, yeah, something that we can still narrow it down to. Look at what we can do to such properties. Look at how we can enhance the potential of such properties and maybe have some sort of agreement with the owners to maybe manage such properties for 18 years, 20 years, 25 years as the case may be, because it still boils down to the location. Okay.
So now, what we're going to just do now, we are going to just go into that basic discussion. So I would like Tayo to please pan his the camera towards the board. And you can just go ahead. Maybe you might need to join.
Okay.
Now, let's take for example. We have a project somewhere in. We have a project located in. Which area should we pick?
Let's look at the case of Surulere.
Let's look at the Surulere Central.
Central.
We have Surulere. And we have a project, maybe a project that we are going to renovate. And the idea is that we want to renovate maybe like a two bedroom. And how many rooms do we have? How many space will we have in the two bedroom?
For a two-bedroom, for the property in Surulere, we might be looking at, let's assume, we can get a, let's say, 18 units.
18 units.
Of a two-bedroom.
Okay. 18 units of two-bedroom.
the property sitting on a ground and two upper floor. It's actually
two bedroom, 18 million. With property sitting on what?
Ground and two upper floor.
Ground and two upper floor. Let's just go into a practical example of how we can achieve, how anybody can invest 200,000 naira with us. Now, I'm looking at a situation, I was having that discussion today with James earlier today. Looking at, okay, oh, I have 200,000 naira. How will my 200,000 naira? And I said, well, you know what? You have a situation whereby we have two bedroom flats will take about, we have maybe about, I think, how many spaces? Maybe about six spaces. Let's take, for example, the sitting room. That's one. Two bedrooms. You have one. You have two bedrooms. Two. You probably have, what? You have the toilet. The toilet, probably two. At least they will have two of it. Then you have somewhere like a kitchen. You have what? Kitchen would be what?
One.
Would be one.
So it makes six.
So you have six spaces you're going to probably renovate or probably develop. Now in this case, what we now do is that, we are now estimating that at least you will have, out of these, you're going to spend, for each of the spaces, you're going to spend probably 200,000 naira to be able to facilitate the renovation of that project. And so we have a situation whereby when you multiply by 200,000 naira by six, you're probably going to get 1.2 million naira. Now, on the average, in areas like, let's say, in this particular area, let's just assume that rental value is at about
800,000
naira.
To 1 million
naira. And so, for a two-bedroom apartment. Let's say, to be modest enough, because we don't want to go up to 1 million naira. Let's say at 840,000 naira is what is being collected here. And now the owner, the landlord, is ready to take 50% of the value in terms of rent for me. As the rent comes in, it's going to be about 420. To the investors now, because now you are putting 1.2 million naira, and what you'll be getting at this particular stage is about 420,000 naira on a yearly basis for the next 15 years. 15 or what? Am I correct? For the next 15 years. So over time, what you'll have been able to generate, that if you are doing about the 1.2 million naira. Now, over time, what you will have been able to do over time is that you'll have been able to generate, I don't know if you have a calculator here.
Yeah, there is.
Okay, can we do a calculation? 420 times 15.
420 times 15?
Yeah. That's about 6.3 million naira.
Is this 6.3 million naira? Yes.
420,000 naira times, can we calculate this again? 420,000 naira.
420 times 15.
Times 15. Yes. That's about 6.3 million naira over 15 years. Now, what you invested at this particular stage is about 1.2 million naira. What your investment has grown into over 15 years is about 6.3 million naira. Now, interestingly, maybe every 3 years or every 5 years, there is what? There's rent increase. And let's okay, from 840, it increases upward to maybe to about, let's say about 900,000 naira, or even you get to a point whereby we can increase to about 1 million naira. What happens is that whatever it is still shared by, it's still shared half
as
dividend, and you can also take your returns get to increase over time. And you know what? Interestingly, what you have just invested is that you have invested one time to be able to generate all of this. Now let us say this: maybe I am the one who probably dropped 200,000 naira out of 1.2 million naira. What I would get in terms of percentage is that when you divide 420 by 6, by the 6 spaces that you currently have, what it means is that you probably get about 70,000 naira every year with your 200,000 naira, which simply means that over 10 years, what you have been able to generate, 700,000 naira.
in 15 years you'll have been able to generate 0.1 million naira from your 200,000 naira. Now what this does for anybody who is investing in real estate is that you are not able to do this in multiplied value. Let's take for example who me who is probably because real estate should be should be for me, I think, in terms of cash flow. Like what you also discussed today, that maybe my rent where I'm currently living is about
let's say you are living in a one-bedroom apartment,
okay,
and then you are practically paying, let's say, 400,000 naira for your rent.
Yeah.
And if you can adopt something of this nature and feel maybe I have some loose funds somewhere, I can actually put in 1 million as opposed to doing a 200,000 naira worth of investment with this. Then it actually means just as opposed to me getting 70k per annum, and I'll most likely be getting 350,000
naira.
So that means that 350,000 naira is practically paying my rent.
I
don't just need to worry myself with rent.
Yes,
I know.
For the next 15 years, you are not paying rent. So what you have been able to do is that something is actually paying certain bills. I always say this, you need something to pay the certain bills that you currently have. And one of the things that real estate does, that real estate gives you leverage. Real estate is an opportunity. Now, for anybody who wants to take advantage of the dynamic, let's say, okay, you guys went somewhere today.
Yeah, to check a couple of properties out.
Yeah, and what did you find?
Yeah, lots of potential in them anyway.
Yeah, because one of the things that we discover within the city, there are major development going on that need cash. Why? For innovation. That is why you find out that we have influx of people who call themselves developers. What they do is that they're able to take advantage of the need of landowners. I say this to people, do you want to be a landlord or do you want to rather be an investor? Now, an investor is somebody who makes money from an investment. He puts money to make money. But a landlord may not necessarily be making money. He may just have a portfolio that is not generating wealth for him. So he has land, like Tadi will say, is a lazy asset. So the land somewhere is not actually generating income for him. So what we are trying to do here is to be able to convert that potential. Let us take, for example, gray areas that have good rental value. Take advantage, because there are some dilapidated houses around town that one can take advantage. You don't necessarily have to be the one doing that. Now, let me state this now. If you try this, our arithmetic, it may not actually work for you. Because you are not yet using the kind of leverage that I will use or that James will use. What you need to be able to look at is, okay, who are the people that I need to be able to leverage myself on? Because you cannot ask somebody to develop, you cannot go and meet somebody who has a two-bedroom or maybe a three-bedroom to develop just one part of the apartment. All you just need to do is to be able to get people involved and leverage yourself with them. So for example, you have 200,000 naira. Your 200,000 naira can grow over time. It can grow to become 700,000 naira. It can also grow to become 7 million naira. Why? Because real estate is gradual. Anybody who wants to make investment, and who tells you that, oh, you can just make all that you want within a space of 7 months or so, may probably be lying to you and not be telling you the entire truth. The truth is that real estate gives you an opportunity to be able to invest in high yield areas. Let's take for example, if you want to own a property or you want to enjoy rental income in areas like Yaba, for example, you don't necessarily have to go and buy a plot of land in Yaba. All you need to just do is to come to this particular level, which is what we call the underground real estate investment economy. You don't necessarily have to be the one who go and buy a particular property. You can own certain investments in certain areas, and that area gives you good income or gives you good bargain for you to be able to put your life in order. We have always said that we need cash flow for our life to keep going. So if you don't have cash flow, your life can't go. So what we just actually need is to invest in cash flow projects. Cash flow projects in Lagos, for example, requires that you invest in areas like Bagada. Is it Bagada?
Bagada.
GBA. Bagada. We have areas like what?
We have some part of Amu Wodofin.
Good areas.
Like,
We have Sulu Lere.
We have Yaba.
We have Yaba.
We have Inukweju.
We have Inukweju.
We have Maryland.
Wow, Maryland.
Yeah. We have Ubuntu.
We have Ubuntu.
Ikeja.
Ikeja. We have Ikoyi.
These are just mainland that
mainland area.
When you start turning towards the community, then you now start looking at foundations that might actually be eating up into it.
So okay.
Because at least those ones do have their own markets.
Yeah, yeah. But these areas that we've mentioned, what are the rental values?
The rental values there, let's look at the two-bedroom flats. A two-bedroom flat around there should most likely minimum be going for 800,000 naira. To 900, 1 million, 1.2. It depends on what kind of facilities you're actually putting into your development.
Yeah, okay. So let's say, okay, now, what you now look at, that there are certain areas that we are going to invest in at a particular time, we decided to pull out, majorly because of the rental value. It's not going to give us good returns. And so we need to be able to look at, okay, areas that have good potential for good returns. And so we invest our money in some kind of places so that you can also generate, anybody can also generate wealth from that place. And this area also have good number of volume, good demand pressure.
Yeah.
Yeah? Good rental value for anybody who is ready to invest and all of that. So those are the things that we look out for when investing. And you can also be part of this, investment opportunity. It's an opportunity. I say this. If I were to come back again, I would do real estate over and over again. Why? Because real estate is leverage. It gives people the kind of cash flow that other businesses may not give. And I beg to say this. Now, what you currently watching now, you might probably think is that, how can I make 200,000 naira be converted? That's what we have actually shown you today. That you can actually use 200,000 naira to start investing. Now, just imagine that I'm able to solve a particular, maybe my rental problem. My rental problem with just 200,000 naira on a yearly basis, or probably maybe with about how much? About a million naira. I'm able to use a million naira to solve my problem, my rental problem for the next 15 years. And I take another million naira again. What do I do? I invest it into my children's school fees for my children's education. And what does that do? It solves that problem again. So I'm not worried about the education for the next 15 years. So I now do another a million naira again. What happens is I now set it out. Okay, yes, maybe for a particular project that I want to embark upon, maybe I want to educate myself. I want to run maybe a PhD program over time and I want to do all of that. I need certain funds to be able to do that. And that one is able to help me scale. Or probably maybe in case of inflation tomorrow, and maybe for emergency case, I have something that I've been able to set aside. So with about 5 million naira over time, what you'll be generating is that you have certain things that will be solving certain problems for you. So you need to be able to think that, okay, what is the wealth ratio that I'm building over time? Because some people are really looking in that direction. That is why it looks as if real estate is not actually for them. Real estate is for everybody. Why? Because what we have currently now, we have about 70 million housing deficit. The government is not going to cure that problem. My father is not going to solve that problem. Neither will your parents solve that problem. Nobody's going to solve the problem except people who will invest into what? Into apartment houses or for rental development. So you can now take advantage of it because the rental market will never run away. It has come to stay. So for you to be able to take advantage of the rental market is for you to be able to invest with whatever you got. What do you have? Do you have somebody is earning something maybe on a monthly basis and is putting money aside? What you just need to just do is to just come and invest in certain things like this so that on a daily basis, on a regular basis, you're able to enjoy rental income. Now we said that we can also do it in such a way that we can break it down to a monthly level whereby somebody on a monthly basis is able to enjoy as much as is enjoying what we call salary for life. So every month is earning about 2.8 to about 2.9% of whatever I invest on a monthly basis. So it's able to enjoy returns every month over a particular period of time. Just imagine for the next 25 years.